So here's some raw footage of my daughter and I biking around Idyllwild Thousand Trails campground. You may have caught a glimpse of our Travato there.
You don't have to go, Hannah.
But her... And you can't really tell, but this is going kind of steep downhill. A lot of the RVs in this area were permanent, so year-round RVers. It was kind of hard to get our Travato up that hill, so I wouldn't recommend it for anything big unless you're going to really put a lot of work into it. This was the closest bathroom. This is bathroom number two, I believe. They were pretty clean, sparsely used. These campsites are the 300 series. A lot of them were a little bit more separated, and then towards the bottom of the hill here, there were campsites with full hookups, but they were pretty packed. Just typical RV parking with nice trees.
You want to go up a hill.
Okay,
so
do this again?
So turn it on.
But how come it doesn't light up? Oh, it is. Okay.
Okay, and then
up one.
Give it like one at least.
Yeah.
You're going to need three eventually.
Okay.
So after the store, we turn left.
Okay.
That's the country store. We didn't go in there. And you heard me giving my daughter some e-bike instructions. This is the first time she was on the e-bikes. And this is our first full weekend using the e-bikes. They're pretty fun, those camp bikes. They are... They're electro...
It is!
Electro-towny goes.
Takes a while to get used to.
Can't really tell, but this is a pretty steep uphill. Definitely needed the full boost.
If it's not giving you enough, you can drop a gear. But like...
Oh, Mom's got it on 7.
Yeah, put it in 3 or so.
Wait, just push it? Like you have a bike?
Yeah.
This hill separated the 300 and 200 campgrounds from the 400, 500, and 600 campgrounds. The hill is near the top of the... Sorry, the pool is near the top of the hill. See, these two areas were pretty separate from each other.
Feels so weird to be going up a hill
like
that.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel right at all.
It's like a cheat.
Yeah.
You're still working.
It's a big trailer coming behind us.
Yeah.
Here's some of the cabins that you can rent for a discount if you're a Thousand Trails member. They all seem very nice.
Oh yeah.
Now we're in the 600s. They start getting pretty packed here. Although this was Sunday and a lot of the folks had already left, actually. And this time, this guy's taking forever to pass us. Sunday afternoon, a lot of people were decamping. It was a lot less packed today than it was the day before. Hey, a couple of airstreams up there. Very cool. Tiny ones.
Yeah, it's like a 18 footer maybe. I mean 19 footer.
So at the top of this trail you can get to it's kind of a
lot of empty spots today.
Yeah, I guess it's Sunday, so
yeah.
I keep interrupting myself. So at the top of this hill, you'll get to the equestrian area and the trailhead for a bunch of different trails, including the Pacific Crest Trail.
And this is where this is a big trailhead here.
3.5 miles?
Something like
that.
No, no, I haven't done that.
Oh.
That leads to a bunch of other trails.
Oh, neat. Oh, that's the way to the PCT?
Yep.
So this looks really inviting now because it's all empty, but when it's full, it feels pretty packed. One of these spots here is a full hookup. That one is full time, this one is full time, and I looked it up.
Let's go this way.
Where that
what?
Green trailer is a
it's a loop,
hookup.
Yeah.
Shuffleboard, if that's your thing. It's kind of a dog run and some sandy volleyball court and a pool for code. They had some use restrictions. You had to get on a waiting list and only 10 people at a time. I never saw it very full. On the way down we'll pass the 400s, another set of campgrounds. They're a little bit more sparse, not quite as sparse as the 300 ones where we stay. But if I went up there and the 300s were full, I would stay in the 400s. I think these are the 400s here. E-bikes are just awesome. I'm barely breathing hard here. These are all 400s here, but they're all like full-timers. I think there's only one spot here that's not a full-time spot. And at the end of here, there's a trailhead for the...
You remember that trail from yesterday?
Uh-huh.
That's where it comes out.
We're going on it?
No, no.
Oh. This is where it starts.
Yeah, that's where it ends, I guess. Or starts.
Oh, wait. So we are not near here.
We're pretty close.
It connects somewhere else.
So the reason we're not taking the bikes on that trail is because these are definitely not trail bikes. Road bikes, a little fatty tires, but not fat enough. We chose the Electras because they each weigh less than 40 pounds when you take the battery off. So they don't exceed the.
I'm going slow because I'm looking for campsites. If we want to move. Oof.
Oh, you were thinking.
So they don't exceed our hitch limit of 100 pounds for two bikes. So here we're going to go down a hill that goes through the 400s, I think. Those guys were loaded for bear.
Wait, let me check this one out.
So we were staying another 2 or 3 days.
I like mine more.
So I was scoping out.
It has water. So far we haven't needed water. We don't have a water hookup in ours. It's the only one. It's broken.
Yeah, our spot had electricity, but no water and no sewer.
Definitely don't want anywhere near here. Yeah.
How some of those bigger ones get in there, the mind boggles. The sites are big enough, it's just that there's a lot of steep kind of lips. So if you have low clearance, that could be a problem. I did see a lot of scraped asphalt.
One looks good.
It's really shady.
It's leafy. But I still like mine more.
We took this video mid August. The lowlands were in the 90s or maybe at 100, and the whole week just it never broke 85 up here. It was very dry and just comfortable. May have gotten a little bit uncomfortable during peak heat in the afternoon. Almost no bugs. We did get bit by like a mosquito, maybe. And when we broke camp like 3 days later and I went to grab my power cord, there was a rattlesnake kind of hiding in it. So that was an adventure. But this is definitely rattlesnake country, so you want to keep your eye out when you're on a trail. There, back in the country store, there's, if it weren't COVID times, there would be a restaurant here, a little ice cream shop. Kind of swing by the there's a little fishing pond. Apparently it's docked with a catfish. You need a fishing license to fish in it. And that little hut there is for cleaning fish. So you don't have to mess up your trailer. What the green stuff is, I have no idea. The day before it was full of kids fishing. Now, this way is not, this road doesn't lead to any RV sites, it's only tent sites. See, the road's a little rougher. If you have a Class B van like ours, you might be able to make it in here, but that would be adventurous. And there's no hookups here at all. The power of water or anything. You see the bicycle hills. You can't really tell this is a hill. It's a pretty steep hill. It's having a rough time getting up. The electric townies only have about 250.
This is only camping. It looks pretty rough up here.
I was saying the electric townies only have about 250 watts of power, so that they're not really suited for steep uphills unless you're willing to put a lot of work in.
Say again? Yeah, they're very heavy.
always tell which RVs are here for the whole year. Have Christmas lights up and little patio furniture. And you have to keep in mind that Idyllwild is a four-season area. It does snow in winter. So we'll have to find an excuse to make it up here in the snowy season. There's a store. I'm going to swing by. I'm not going to go in.
No,
I think it's closed.
Yeah.
Just a little campfire area. No wood burning in Thousand Trails. So if you want to make a s'more, you need a gas pit. Portable gas pit.
Out of there. Yeah.
This I found to be a pretty cool site. I think I'm gonna go in there to check it out. Maybe I did it in another video, but if we came back, this site up here might be interesting. It seemed pretty isolated. Back there is another trailhead. Really nice trail. Short, about 0.3 miles, not a lot of elevation, but some great views.
That's kind
of
it.
Oh, I see. Here it is.
Yeah.
Again, here we go up the hill to our site. Doesn't seem like much in the video. You can tell the bike gets a lot of trouble getting up sandy areas. And there we are.
Oh.
I hope you enjoyed the view.
What?
What's
I mean, we. I haven't charged that one. Yeah, mine is completely full. Off?
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean,
mine's off.
I know that, like, the area, like, where my parents live and, like, everything, like,